August 6th, around the same time after the defeat of the fascist French forces in the Netherlands, the general of the Second Royal Hungarian Army was forced to fight against the Romanian generals of Eastern Slavia. This dissolution of the Union of the United Romanian, Hungarian, Slovakian, and Moldavian Republic would result into all-out war between the Slavic Republic. The general of the major offensive to regain the lost territories under Alba was Gustav Janke. Romanian forces on the first hours of the morning on August 7th. This first offensive was notably successful. The forces he used to regain this lost territory positioned the Laszlo assault groups. The Hungarian army was well prepared for the sudden dissolution of their union, as they made a military border between the territories of Moldova and Romania between Hungary and Slovakia. This line was called the Banat-Lemmer's line, and this is where the Hungarians would fight against the Romanian counterparts. The lesser Balkan power at the time was the Communist Socialist Republic of Slavia, which was made up of the territories of Western Macedonia and as well as Bulgaria. Their government considered the following actions that should be taken. One notable thing that was always noted about the Hungarian army was their own extensive creation of their own type of tank, one of the most notable ones being the Tyrann series, mostly being straight-off copies of German panzers. They were still an effective fighting force nonetheless. First Battle of Alba. Part of the battle was during the capture of the major railroad station in the northern part of Alba. This is where a conscript platoon led by Gabor Kiss was sent to the railroad station to capture them. This capture the team of Kevin first and was a saw the first use of a Hungarian self-produced heavy tank in the Task 44 hammer, which was noticeably compared to a mix of the German Panther and the Soviet Union's IS-1. This tank is armed with a 75mm weapon, a 75mm tank cannon, a K-42, and a bot from the German government. Reported they were supported by light tank forces such as Panther 3Ns and also Marders. After a human wave tactic employed by the Romanian Guard infantry, they were finally able to capture the village in the southern part of the as rapid mechanized forces of the Shindla's lower assault groups were sent to the recapture of the southern troops. The lesser of Gustav Jani was the second in command, Attila Takax. This man would lead the forces of the Hungarian Second Army and its first division of Schindler's lower assault groups to victory.
So it wasn't very effective.
A notable deployment in this battle was an anti-tank crew led by Kevin Szabo, who was in command of a 20mm Sullivan anti-tank gun. Effectively, what this was just a ridiculously oversized anti-tank rifle loaded in between the we'll be right back. However, this stands no chance against the Hungarians now most likely in battle combat. Efficient route as before. This tank will become the major reality of the Hungarian forces and the Imperial army. To extend can you just destroy the Imperial First TAS 44 was engaged by a Romanian IS-2, which proved to be quite a scary vehicle, proven by the Soviet Union beforehand. But now, this heavy-hitting vehicle had just taken out the main battle tank of Hungarian army. However, this would not stand to last. Would allow for the Hungarian forces to recuperate and defensive. Further improvements from the battle, very late into this first battle of Alba, did the Romanians deploy the Lend-Lease Panthers from the Imperial German forces. However, it was too late, as the Hungarians completely unable to set up a proper defense against the Romanian forces.